Kia ora, one direction. Welcome to New Zealand. You're here finally.
Thank you.
Now tell me, the last six months must have been madness. The UK, the US, I mean, how insane is this?
Crazy.
For us, it's been absolutely mad. Obviously, we're just five normal lads, and we've been going to places that in the world we've never been before, and been having an amazing reception. The fans have been absolutely incredible. It's been, for us, it's just been so much fun. Obviously, getting to travel the world with each other, having a lot of fun, it's great.
Well, you touched on it. You're five normal lads. Well, your life's changed forever. You're not normal anymore. I mean, is that a regret, or is this just the best adventure?
No, we're having a great time. I think, you know, we're still just as normal as ever. You know, we still do the same things that we usually do. You know, we love to have a mess about and stuff and just have a laugh. So, yeah, we're still normal lads.
The X Factor program, you know, it's a worldwide hit. What would your advice be to someone who's looking for the courage to be part of a program like this?
I think that's a key thing. You just said it there. Just have the courage to kind of go and audition for it, you know. Don't let your nerves hold you back, and don't let confidence hold you back. If you've got a good voice and you've got talent, just go and show off. Go show your talent to the world.
It's very easy to sit at home and think, you know, I've got absolutely no chance of getting through. But actually, that's pretty much what we thought, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's just take the chance.
Yeah, I think there's a big element of having fun with it as well, and just, you know, not taking it all too seriously and just having a good laugh, because you've got to enjoy what goes on at the start and yeah, have a good time. That's what it's all about. That's the reason you get into this sort of thing, is to have a good time.
How did you know you could sing? When did you find out you can sing? Do you sing at the radio? I mean, how did that happen?
A lot of it wasn't actually singing with the radio stuff.
A lot of it was just like school stuff, I think, from my
school choir, yeah.
And yeah, I think I started in choir, you started in choir.
I started in choir, yeah.
I did a musical at school.
But yeah, just I think it's all just school stuff, and then just progressing from there. And yeah, just other people kind of tell you, you know, to think you've got a good voice. And
I think it kind of starts with your mum, normally. Your mum usually says...
Yeah, but you never know, trust that, because every mum's going to say, you're a great singer.
Does she mean it?
You've been lucky enough to have Simon Cowell involved in your life. I mean, what advice did he give you, and, you know, what's the man like?
He's actually a really nice guy.
He's a really nice guy. He's really funny. He's always up for a laugh. He's always there for us if we need him. You know, people think that he's, you know, he comes across that very serious character on TV, but whenever we're around him, we always have a good laugh.
As far as advice goes, right on the show, right at the start, he said, you guys need to be the band that you want to be, which is, you know, it was perfect for us. That's exactly what we wanted to do, and, you know, keep it as real as possible.
I mean, he wants you to be real. He wants you to be, you know, he's a hit-making factory. Did he feel that this was the best place for you to be? I mean, was he going to be looking after you, making sure...
I think, you know, we've just been given such a great opportunity, and obviously when we started off the album, you know, he gave us a lot of freedom to, you know, choose the kind of sound that we wanted to do, how we wanted the band to go, you know, what went on the album. If we didn't like song lyrics and stuff, we could change them and stuff. So, you know, I think this was a great position for us to be in, and we couldn't really, you know, have picked a better one, you know.
Some people are flipped outside.
They're going crazy, aren't they? Mm. Liam, look, I understand you went to trouble with school bullies, and this is something that's raising its ugly head in New Zealand at this stage. I mean, what advice could you give to, or any of the band, to someone watching this, how to deal with this?
I think the best thing to do is just to tell someone, let somebody know, and then, you know, you can deal with it from there, sort of thing. If you stay quiet about it, then nothing happens, you know, it'll just stay the same. So just make sure you tell someone.
Was it a lonely time? Do you feel alone, or how did you, you know, resolve this?
You went to the gym.
You just stood up to him, didn't you?
Yeah, you just kind of have to stand up to it a little bit. I think, you know, if you make yourself a target and make yourself easy to be picked on and just let things happen, then that's what happens. But if you go, you know, you do something and you're active about it and you make sure that something's done about it, then, you know, it'll slowly stop.
Because it's not just at school bullying, there's Facebook and there's Twitter, there's a whole lot of ways how do we feel about those?
I think it's, you know, obviously sometimes we get some horrible comments and stuff said about us on Twitter and Facebook. The best thing you can do with that is just ignore it, because, you know, it's just words on the internet. You just kind of have to ignore it, or once again just tell someone about it. But people could be very brave, sat behind a computer screen,
exactly,
knowing that they're comfortable, and you can just sit behind a computer and type things, but there you go.
I'm sure as soon as you confront someone like that, they'd just go red-faced and wouldn't say anything.
Yeah.
Girlfriends. Time for girlfriends. Look, you're travelling the world. How do you meet somebody? I mean, you're five red-blooded guys.
We're alive.
Me and Liam have we've got girlfriends.
Yeah. So I met mine very, very early on when we just started out. So, you know, I've been having with my girlfriend a while now, and it works fine for me, so it's good.
Single lads?
Single ladies.
We have a lot of fun, I think. On the road a lot, we get to travel a lot, we meet
new people all the time.
Because the travelling, is there a sacrifice, a personal or social life? Sacrifice for the music or for this opportunity?
I think naturally with anything, I think there's always going to be sacrifice, I think. You know, obviously we don't get to go home that much, so we don't see our family and friends like loads. But, you know, the opportunity that we have, I don't think any of us would change, because it's been absolutely amazing for us. I don't think any of us would change anything. It's been amazing. So, you know, it's just kind of what it is.
The Australian tour, I mean, we saw the pictures here, the fan reaction. This fan reaction is everywhere. How are we coping with this? This is pretty extreme, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, we don't think it's something it's a funny way of expressing it, say, cope with. I don't think it's something you really have to cope with. You just kind of enjoy it, really. You know, we have a good time, and it's nice that the fans are so supportive, and they like to, you know, turn up and show that they're supportive, so it's great.
It's having each other around. We all say that we don't know if we'd be able to hack it as solo artists, you know, because there is a lot of travelling and a lot of time away from home, but that's why it's great, you know, having four of your best mates around you.
Well, what's the most extreme fan experience?
There's been so many crazy fan experiences.
Yeah. Someone once asked to lick my face. It's quite an extreme one. Didn't quite know how to react to that.
Somebody once bought us to a sign, and they bought us like a phone. They'd bought us a phone, and then they'd put like just their number in it. And then obviously they had the number of the phone, so they would like keep calling this phone that they gave us, and they were like, "You can text me off this phone." So that was pretty crazy.
Yeah, and the one time when we were in New York, as I know, we just finished a show in Music City. Radio City. We just finished a show in Radio City, or Music City, as I like to call it. And we took off down the street in the car, but the fans just chased you down the street, and there was like hundreds of girls just running after the car in the street. It was mad outside Music City.
And sometimes girls flash their boobs.
Everyone's a winner.
I mean, if you five guys wandered into a London pub, you might not have noticed. Why do you think this happens? I know you're in boy band. Why do they go for a band? Why do girls do this?
I think with us it might be. I mean, we don't actually really know. You know, we often sit down and think, I wonder what it is that you know, we just feel like we're just five lads, you know, from the UK and Ireland that are just completely normal. So I don't really know. I think it might be that we're just normal, and we, you know, I think people might be able to relate to us. I think maybe that's a factor.
In concert, when you're performing, what's the feeling when
look at these bees.
You're getting the feedback from the audience? What's the rush you're getting? You're a musician, you know, you're performers.
Yeah, it's definitely the best feeling. It's the best part of the job to get up on stage and perform to thousands of people. And we've been doing this for 2 years, and we haven't had a bad crowd. We've got very dedicated fans, very loud fans, and you know, we've had some great shows, and it's a really good feeling. I've had a lot of them pinch yourself moments. You get goosebumps, hairs on the back of your neck, mate. You get like, when you hear them singing the song back, like Liam got the crowd to sing the first verse of one of our songs the other night, and it was mind-blowing. Like, it was crazy. It's definitely the best thing.
And is that the addiction of the crowd and the live performance that keeps you going, striving?
Yeah, I think 100%. By far touring and performing on stages like that to fans is by far the best part of the job, and I think we'd all agree that. I think, you know, when we, you know, like Liam does, get the fans singing back to you, I think that is a bit that is kind of that big rush when you have like a stadium, not a stadium, when you have like a big arena of people singing back to you, is amazing for you.
The second album is always perhaps harder than the first. What can we expect? Come on, secrets on, you know, worldwide.
It is going to be difficult, you know, there's more pressure on us, you know, for this album, but I think it's going to be more of the same, but hopefully we're going to have a bit more writing on there. I mean, we wrote on three of the tracks on Up All Night, so we hope we're going to get more writing on there. As far as the sound,
we're getting a bit older, I think, so, you know, the lyrics can get a bit older with us as well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think just as we get older, you know, the music can progress with us.
Yeah, I think the music will just grow as we grow.
It's going to be, it's going to be more of the same, but hopefully, you know, a little bit better.
Is there someone, is there a current influence that hits, you know, a sound you're enjoying at the moment?
I don't think there's a direct influence. I think we just kind of have our own kind of thing, don't we?
But yeah.
People say it's like Pink meets a boy band.
I think the one thing for us is like we want a really live sound now. I think that's the biggest influence for us. If we want something that sounds live, like when you hear it on the radio, it doesn't sound, you know, like really manufactured, but it's live. That's the kind of thing we want. So we go with like the instruments and stuff, and you know, a lot of guitars, heavy drums. So I think that's the main thing. For
it's
us.
Almost a little bit Katy Perry as well. Yeah. She is quite guitar-driven pop, so that's a good influence for us as well.
You're down the Antipodean part of the world. What did you know about New Zealand before you came here?
Great rugby team.
The ratio of sheep to people, what is that?
9 to 1.
That is insane.
And the bungee jump was invented here.
Any intentions of doing the jump?
We started to talk about it.
You can do it off the Sky Tower, right? I was told that on the way back.
I'm 100% game for doing a bungee jump.
I want a cliff dive.
I like the idea of cliff diving and skydiving. I'm not sure.
I just want to shear a sheep.
The attraction of jumping off something, is that a rush that you need? Is that what? Is it insane or not?
For the past few days, me and Lou have been out like surfing.
I think that was a
huge one for that. That's a big buzz to go out and you get a bit of adrenaline from that. But I think I would love to do a bungee.
Yeah. I'd like to skydive, but for some reason bungee jump just scares me.
I think the only reason why I wouldn't bungee jump, I've seen it and you kind of get like thrown around loads.
So skydiving, sheep, a shearing, bungee jumping. These are all on the plans. Has there anything else been booked by the company?
At one point, it probably won't be this trip, but we'd love to go jet skiing.
Yeah, jet skiing would be fun.
What else is there to do? New Zealand style.
Play rugby.
Yeah.
Would that be it? Have you ever played rugby?
Yes.
Yeah, we played it at school.
Then we were younger. I'm Irish, so we played it.
Hence the British and Irish Lions.
English game.
I know we've got a final shot. Just following the reports.
One of my ex-girlfriends from home, her mum was from New Zealand.
I'm pretty sure I've got family in New Zealand, actually. I'm pretty sure I've got family in New Zealand. I've never met, but I'm pretty sure, actually. I'm going to double check with my nana after this interview.
Wonder Richard, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
I think your nana's sister.
Marco, I want to go bungee jumping.
Oh, no, she lives in Canada. That's right.